Intermittent fasting is an eating pattern where you eat all of your meals during a certain time of the day or during a certain window of the day. And when you're not eating, you're fasting, which is why it's called intermittent fasting. You're intermittently incorporating a fast. I've seen a lot of concern around intermittent fasting and starvation, but it's really important to note that intermittent fasting is not inherently a form of calorie restriction. You're not necessarily eating less, you're just eating less often. In other words, you're still getting your daily nutrient needs during that eating window. You're just not spreading out those needs throughout the day. And by switching that eating pattern from multiple small meals throughout the day or snacking versus intermittent fasting and eating during that specific window each day, a few key things happen. First of all, insulin typically naturally lowers. Insulin is our storing hormone, so especially if you have a weight loss goal in mind, this is really important. Because when insulin levels are high, fat burning, or the process called lipolysis, is turned off. But when insulin levels are allowed to naturally dip back down, like when fasting, this allows that fat burning process to be turned back on. This is probably why a review of intermittent fasting and weight loss studies found that intermittent fasting is uniquely great at actually utilizing fat as fuel, which if you're looking to achieve a weight loss goal, you don't want to be losing bone or muscle, you want to be losing fat. Another thing that typically happens with intermittent fasting is that growth hormone tends to go up. And this is our muscle protecting hormone, which doubles down on that desire to make sure that you're maintaining muscle mass while still achieving a weight loss goal. And then the third really important thing that happens with intermittent fasting that isn't talked about as much is that the gut cleaning process called the migrating motor complex is turned on. And this only turns on when you're not eating. And the migrating motor complex helps to flush out left behind food and bacteria that typically can cause bloating in the GI tract. Now you can follow various lengths of an intermittent fast. For example, this can range anywhere from a 12-hour daily fast to a 22-hour daily fast. When you start and end your fast will really depend on the length of time that you're choosing to fast each day. Which if you're new to intermittent fasting and you want an idea of how you can actually determine the fasting length that's best for you, I created a short free quiz you can take. I'll have that link down in the description below. Now for example, if you choose to have a 14-hour fast, then this means that your eating window or the time that you will be eating each day is going to be 10 hours. I usually recommend starting off when you know that you can eat dinner and counting backwards to determine when your eating window will be. So if you're normally done eating dinner by 8 p.m., then this means that you would start your fast at 8 p.m. and then break your fast at 10 a.m. So your eating window is 10 a.m. to 8 p.m. and you're fasting from 8 p.m. to 10 a.m. the next day. Now during the actual fast itself, you're not consuming anything that will spike the storing hormone insulin. Otherwise, you don't really get the benefits of intermittent fasting. Now, what you consume during that fast will also vary depending on your goals. This could be as simple as just water and electrolytes, especially if you're looking for more of those gut healing benefits. That's the route that you'll likely want to go. Or you could incorporate unsweetened teas and coffee, or even a keto coffee option, which utilizes a little bit of a pure fat source that does not stimulate insulin, but will help to keep you satiated during that fasting period. This route is particularly great if you are new to intermittent fasting and you find that in the beginning you're getting a little bit hungry, which I also have a super short video on what breaks a fast, which you can check out right here. Now, something that's often forgotten is to consider what you're eating during your eating window. If you're incorporating intermittent fasting, but you're still eating super high insulin spiking foods, then you're likely not only going to not achieve your weight loss goal, you're probably going to end up gaining weight. Another issue is just simply not eating enough for your nutrient needs within that eating window, which can make you feel really hungry and even result in muscle loss and make it just not a sustainable practice. This is where a lot of people tend to go wrong with intermittent fasting, is not considering their eating window. In fact, these are just a couple of the really common mistakes I see all the time with intermittent fasting. You can check out the 10 most common intermittent fasting mistakes I see all the time with this video next. Also, if you're new to my channel and you love the science-backed information, make sure you subscribe right here. Come out with new videos every Tuesday and Thursday. All right, guys, thanks so much for tuning in, and I'll see you in my next video.